Hello everybody, my name is Maddie and welcome back to my channel. But if you're new, welcome to my channel. Before we get into everything today, first make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on that bell to know when I post. It would just mean so much to me. And also follow all of my social media and check out my merch. I will put it in the description down below. So today, you guys wanted a video of me talking about my side cut and just like a general video about it. And I was like, okay, I got you. I could serve. I could do that. Easy. So I'm gonna kind of just touch on different things that have to do with the side cut, like, you know, what it is, how I take care of it, and some pros and cons of having a side cut. So with all of that out of the way, let's get right into it. A side cut is when you have a part of your head just shaved. So you can have like an undercut just on the back of your head right here, or you can have both sides shaved, or you can have one side. I just have the side of my head shaved. I did this myself when I was 15, so I've had it for 7 years now, and it was pretty terrible when I did it myself, but now that I know how to do it and I upkeep it myself, I'm able to talk from someone with experience about, like, you know, having it and how to take care of it and all that fun stuff. I've had it for quite a while. I'm your side cut sensei is what I'm trying to get at. Something that was really like what I heard a lot when I first did it myself was that I was going to regret it because I was a little 15-year-old and I wanted it so bad. My mom didn't let me go get it done, so I did it myself, and everyone was like, oh no, like, you are going to hate that in a couple of weeks. You're gonna wish you never got it done. And if I sound weird, I just ate so much food, so I'm really full right now. Anyways, yeah, like, everybody was like, oh, that is such a mistake. And it wasn't, because I still have it and I don't think it's going anywhere anytime soon, you know? So yeah, we're gonna talk about like some of my personal tips, because I messed up the parting of it. So I did have to leave some parts grow out, and it was just kind of like a whole mess. But, you know, we'll get into that in a little bit here. First, we're gonna talk about like how you are going to do a side cut. If you want to do it yourself, I recommend probably going to a salon or a barber or whoever. But, you know, if you really want to do it yourself, first make sure you have your parents' permission if you're under 18. And if you're anything like me, maybe you probably won't listen, which that is out of my control. I'm not here to, you know, raise anyone's kids, but that would probably be a good idea because my mom nearly killed me. The general rule of thumb when you're parting your hair to give yourself a side cut is, I'm taking one of my hair picks that is covered in my hair. Is if I'm looking in a mirror, you want to start the parting like somewhere right here. You see how there's like a little V here? Mine is a little higher up just because I like how it looks. And also, like, whenever I parted down here, the hair kept like falling over it, so I moved it up a little bit, and then just go straight back like through the crown of your head. So you see how you have the crown right here, and you go back that way. And then for me, mine ends a little bit behind my ear, so I just went straight up. And then you part your hair like that, you tie it off, cut it and shave it, and you pray. That is like how I gave it to myself. When I first gave myself a side cut, I parted my hair like way up here, and it was such a mess, like such an actual mess. And I didn't have an actual razor. I didn't have any access to a razor, so I just tried making it even with scissors, and it was just so bad and so embarrassing, and it looked really bad. So I will show you the razor that I use to, you know, take care of my side cut and how I make it look good. So my side cut is grown out about a week right now. I probably could stand to shave it, but I usually shave it like once every 2 weeks, because sometimes if I'm feeling ballsy or like, you know, ready to go, I'll shave it once a week. You're gonna want to shave it before a shower, or else you're gonna be itchy as hell. And this is the razor I use. It's just this Remington one. I don't know how much it was because it was a gift. This is what it is. This is how much it is. I'll put all the information for it right here because I honestly don't know, and maybe I should have done that research before I turned on the camera, but I didn't. So yeah, it's just this one. It comes with a bunch of attachments, and the one attachment I use is the 1/16 of an inch, which is attachment number 0. It's the shortest one, I believe, because I definitely like it when my side cut is nice and short. I think it looks cool and it looks nice and clean cut. And that's pretty much all you have to do for upkeep and how I did it personally. Like I said, you just part, cut, shave, and you keep shaving it, and that's all you do. It's really easy to have. It's easy to do on your own, but you have to get the parting right because that's where I dropped the ball. And then I parted it like super far up my head, and then when I realized like, wow, I hate this, I had to like start shaving it where I wanted the new part to be at. And then I had like these baby hairs growing out like up here, so like all of this hair right here like took forever to grow out, and it was very annoying. It was very annoying, and that's why I put a lot of emphasis on be very sure on the part you want, like how much of it you want shaved. You can always shave more, but you can't shave less. You can't put hair back on. So start small with your parting, see how you like it. If you want it to be a bigger part, you can shave more hair off. So now I'm gonna go into some tips that maybe you wouldn't hear normally whenever people are talking about their side cut. My personal tips that I've learned from having it for this long is make sure you use two mirrors when you're shaving so you can see it, and so you don't accidentally like shave a part of your hair back here, because that can be easy to do if you can't see. So what I mean by that is like you're gonna be looking at like one mirror, and then you're gonna take another one like this, or more so like this, like that. There I am. Oh gosh, is that what my profile looks like? That's terrifying. So you're gonna like prop it up usually on a countertop like that, and do that to shave your side of your head so you don't mess up. I was having such a hard time. I used to have like my friends shave that part for me, or just like do a Hail Mary toss and cross my fingers that I'm not shaving like part of my long hair. Also get it on the side that you usually part your hair on. So I always parted my hair this way, so I got it on this side. Okay, so now that we got all of that out of the way, we can talk about pros and cons of having a side cut, because there is pros and cons. And I think just so we can get the negative ish out of the way, I'm probably gonna start off with the cons, because we don't want to end the video on a negative note, you know. So the biggest con that I had when I first got it, I don't really have this anymore actually at all, is people's opinions. People can be assholes. I had my side cut done when I was in school, still like in high school. People said a lot of mean things to me about it, so just get prepared for that. It also probably depends on what kind of area you live in. I live in a very more conservative area, I guess. I don't know, like I don't want to be so sounding so close-minded or like that about people, but I'm not in a very open-minded area. So I did have a lot of people, I had this one girl specifically like say to me, it looks like a lawnmower ran over my head. That was really nice. Yeah, you might have some people saying some things to you, but that also depends on your age and when you get this done. The older I've gotten, I've never had anyone say anything mean besides like, you know, they think it's cool, like, you know, so that's pretty sick. And also depending on the length that you shave it, I do mine really short now, so I don't have this problem anymore, but I used to when I kept it a little longer when I was younger. If you sleep on this side, your hair will stick up like crazy, and every morning or every time you want to go out and do something, you're gonna have to wet it and smooth it down, get some gel to keep it down, and that gets really frustrating. It gets really frustrating to do that every morning, and especially because you probably shouldn't be washing your hair every day. If you do that, you should probably stop. Yeah, like you'd wake up and it's not a hair washing day, but your hair is sticking out like crazy over here, and you're like, what the fuck? If you have a longer side cut, it will stick out like crazy if you sleep on that side. And if you decide you don't want your side cut anymore, you are pretty limited on hairstyles to do to cover it up until it's fully grown out, because it is gonna look funny as hell as it's growing out. And I would know that because, like I said, I messed up my parting. So the only way that you can cover it up is like flipping your hair over to the side. And that's pretty much it. I'm sure there's gonna be way more creative ways that people can think of that you can cover it up, but that still just goes to show that if you want this to grow out, you're kind of stuck with that. You know what I mean? You're kind of stuck with that until it's fully grown out, which can be annoying, you know? So just be prepared for the commitment that comes with it, I guess is what I'm saying. Because if you don't want it anymore, you're gonna be growing your hair out for a minute. Another thing that could be a con is the fact that the upkeep for it is every 1 to 2 weeks. So if you're just like, you don't wanna do that, that can be annoying. It is pretty quick. I just do it before I shower, once every 1 or 2 weeks. And like I said, you want to shower after or else you're gonna be so damn itchy, like so itchy. Something else I noticed was a small con, something that doesn't personally bother me, but this was actually a comment that some dude made to me, and it was like kind of rude, and I was like, what the fuck is your problem? But sometimes like your braids, or like if you have two braids down the side, or if you have like piggytails up here, they can look a little lopsided because you have more hair on this side and less on this side. It's not like, it doesn't really bother me. It's not that much of a drastic difference. Depending on how much hair you do cut off, it can be a drastic difference. So yeah, if your favorite hairstyle is Sailor Moon hair or braids, it could look a little you know, but it's nothing too noticeable, like at all. And also what I do whenever I have braids in is I just like pull the braids out a little more on this side, so it looks just as voluptuous as this side. And also say goodbye to French braids. If you were like the type of bitch that liked having French braids this way, or like the symmetrical French braids, I should say, you could still do like some cool French braid thing like that if that's like your cup of tea or something. Yeah, if you like, you know, always did French braids this way or had like one down the middle, that is kind of hard to do with a side cut. So again, if that's a typical hairstyle of choice that you reach for, think twice about getting a side cut. It's a little hard to look all symmetrical with your hair when you got one side shaved, you feel me? But that is pretty much it for all the cons. It's nothing really too intense, but now we can go to the pros, because there's a lot more pros of having a side cut. Number one is it just looks cool as fuck. Bro, it looks so cool. I don't know, I've always loved it, and that's why people are always like, oh, like, you still have it? Aren't you sick of it? I'm like, no, it's like a part of my look now, you know? Like, I don't think I could ever, like, not have it, I'm gonna be honest. This video is gonna be funny if I decide to grow it out. Somebody's just gonna take that clip and be like, huh? I've never been like, oh, I wish I didn't have it. Like, it's never affected any of my hairstyles that I do. I think it just adds a cool look. I think it's fun when, this one place I worked at, I had to wear a hat whenever I worked there, and, like, I always had a bun parted down the center, so it like covered my hair. And then just like one day at the end of my shift, I like took off my hat, and I was like, finally, I'm done working. And I remember like everyone had no idea that I had the side of my head shaved, and it was just funny watching everyone's reaction. They were all like, oh my god, what, that's so cool. I don't know, I think it just looks so dope, and I think it gives me a cool edgy look. Yeah, so I don't know, like, it just looks cool, and it does give you a fun unique look if that's what you're going for. And also it can really complement your face and jawline. I like that you can see, like, I have more ear piercings on this side because of my side cut. I'm not even kidding. I just feel like you could see my jaw and my cheekbones. And I don't know, like, I think it looks like it can really look good on your face, especially if you have a popping jaw. Girl, like, do it. Like, 1000%. Like, I don't think my jaw is the most popping jaw out there, but I think it makes it look really cool. Another big pro is you can go to barbers and get really cool designs in it. I've only done it once, and I'm going to find the picture and put it here because it looks so dope. And I'm sorry for how my makeup looks and my hair color and everything, because this was a very long time ago and I didn't know what I was doing. Just pay attention to the design in my hair. It looks so sick. And I want to do it again. I just like haven't really thought to, you know what I mean? Like, it was just one of those things that like I knew someone and they were like, oh, well, like, I know a barber, let's get you in on the barber so they can do your hair. And I was like, word. The last pro is it's very easy to cover up, like very easy. So I feel like this is the best argument if you want to get it in your parents are like no, or whatever you're worried about, because I have so many ways to do my hair, and you can just look through my YouTube videos and see that it looks like I don't have it at all. I do part my hair down in the center a lot. That's one of my favorite ways to do my hair. I can flip it over the other side and cover it up. Like, you can do like a low bun down here with your hair parted down the center and it covers it up. So like if you're worried about like not looking professional, it is very simple to make it look like you don't have it, very easy, and there's a lot of options. It's a big commitment, but at the same time, it's also easy to put it away. It's kind of like the septum ring of hairstyles, because septum rings, I mean, not this one, but most septum rings, you can flip them up if you have them done. That's why a lot of like people who are in professional fields will get septum rings done. So it's kind of like the same thing. So I think that's pretty awesome. But I think that is just my all-encompassing video about my side cut, my history, how long I've had it. I will try to put in as much pictures and references as I can. But I hope this was helpful for those of you who asked about a video. It's definitely a part of me and my look, and I'm really happy I have it. I will see you guys next week with a new video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and all that fun stuff. Stay out of trouble, and you guys are adorable sweet peas, and I will see you then. Bye, guys.